So, what is Motioneer? It's a motion engine. It lets you copy, store, and reuse layers and masks animations in a smart way. Let's start by adding the red layer animations to the blue layer. In order to do that, I can select the transformation keys and click on the copy button here. As you see, almost everything freezes. I can only choose to add or to replace animations. Let's add first. Then I select the target layer and the added animation start time point. Look, Motioneer attached the animation seamlessly. In fact, in the composition, it starts where the original animation ends. If I need to attach the animation before the original animation, I just move the time bar and I add again. The added animation ends where the original one starts. Okay, now let's undo. To exit the copy mode, I just click on the copy button again. The script gets back to the full state. If I select and I copy only some keys, like position, for example, only the selected keys will be attached to the target layer. Okay, let's undo. What if I want to add a mask? Well, let's select, copy, and add. Look, Motioneer asks if I want to add the mask to the original layer mask. If I click no, nothing happens. The mask is not added. But if I select yes, the new mask is added. Now, look at the mask's opacity. The old mask swaps with the added one, so up to this frame, the old mask opacity is 100% and the new mask is 0. From next frame, the opacity values are inverted and the new mask is fully active. It also works by adding the mask before the animation, of course. To copy layer transformations and masks all, I select just the layer itself and nothing more. Let's copy. Motioneer will add all the transformations and masks present on the source layer. Add. Yes, mask 2. As you see, the mask opacity swap is present. So the mask changes. And if I select and I add the anim before the original one, a third mask is added. It changes at the first adding time and at the second one. Position animation is motion path based. Motioneer lets you transform the motion paths with a very simple and powerful tool. Let's select some position keys and click on the edit tool. Here, a guide layer is generated. Now, all the selected keys paths are shown, and every transformation edit affects only the motion paths, not the other layers' properties. It also works with 3D rotation or scale. The layer is still here. When I'm done editing, I just click on the edit tool again, and the 3D edited paths are converted to real 2D motion again. Okay, let's undo. Motioneer edit affects all the keys. What I'm gonna do is to make the layer fits the comp horizontal sides. Left side. Okay, let's move to the end of the animation and scale the guide to fit the right side. Well, I think it's a pretty good edit. I exit the edit mode. Let's check. Yeah, it works. To remove animations from selected layers, there is this tool. It removes every mask and transformation keys on the layer, freezing it at the current time state. It also removes track mats, expressions, and parenting. But I'll face this part later, okay? Let's undo and talk about replacing animations. I copy all the blue layer animations, then I select the red target layer, and I choose the replace option. OK. Replace erases everything from the layer and sets the copied animation as the current one. As you see, it is a perfect replica of the copied animation. As for the Add tool, it is also possible to replace only selected properties, keys, and masks. One more thing, if I try to replace or add the copied animation on multiple selections, an alert message shows up. That's because the source layer's selection and the target layer ones don't match. In fact, I copied just one layer. So Motioneer asks to select one layer to match the selection. Done. And now it works, of course. The copied animation is related to the current layer and composition size. If I resize the comp, let's say 1600 by 700, as you see, the animation doesn't fit the comp anymore. I hide the blue layer to make it clear. Copy mode is still active. Let's try to replace again. Look, Motioneer automatically resizes the animation to make it perfectly identical to the original copied one, whose fit the comp size. Or if the layer size is different? Well, let's try. Layer settings. 300 by 200. It doesn't fit the comp again, of course. Replace again. Motioneer did the job. And it doesn't matter the comp or layer size, Motioneer replace tool always sets the animation as the original one. One more thing about mask selection. Look at this animation. I animated the mask path and I modified the feather and expansion properties. If I select the mask without selecting its properties and then I copy and I add or replace on a different layer, Motioneer adds the mask with all its modified properties, so the path animation and also the feather and expansion. Okay, let's undo, and now I select only the feather property. Copy again, and as you see, the mask is added, but now only the feather property is set, not the other mask properties. So again, the rule is that there are two ways, copy masks themselves or copy masks selected properties. Motioneer is very precise. How does Motioneer handle multi-selections? Well, look at the animation here. Okay, now pay attention. I select the bottom source layer first and the top source layer later. It doesn't matter the layer's selection order. When I copy the layers, Motioneer always sets the copied data from the top selected layer to the bottom selected layer. This is also true for the target layers. It doesn't matter the selection order. As you see, the top layers are aligned. And the bottom layers are aligned too. Motioneer always applies data from top target layer to bottom target layer. The same rule applies to multi-layer selected properties. Let's undo. Look, I select the mask path on the bottom layer and the position property on the top layer. I copy and add again, without taking care of the selection order. The mask I selected on the source bottom layer is present on the bottom target layer, and the position previously selected on the source top layer is applied to the target top layer. In this comp, there are two layers, one text layer and one shape layer. The animation is very simple. Let's try to edit the position paths. Well, in order to proceed, I need to pre-compose them. That's because text and shape layer's anchor point is not absolute. I can also decide to always pre-compose text and shapes. Motioneer won't ask me again. I click yes to proceed. The layers are now comps. I move the guide just a bit, and I exit the edit mode. The layers are still comps, so if I need to edit the paths again, they are ready. If I want to unprecompose the layers again, I just click on the remove button. Motioneer detects that they were previously precomposed, and so not only removes the animations, but also unprecomposed them. Well, I undo all, and I copy the layers. When I try to replace the animations, again, Motioneer asks me to pre-compose to proceed. Yes, everything works fine.
Look here. The first layer's rotation is enhanced by a bounce expression. Then the layer star, which is parented to the first layer. In fact, the star follows Motioneer position and rotation. Then the last layer, rotation, revealed by a track matte solid. So this animation holds expressions, parented layers, and track mats. Let's select all the layers and copy. And then I'm gonna paste it in another comp. As you see, here there are only 3 layers. Why not 4? Well, Motioneer doesn't count the track mat layer because every time it generates a track mat based on target layer size. Layers selected and replace. The bounce expression is also present. The box layer is parented to the first layer as expected. Here it is the track mat solid. As I said before, the track mat is generated considering the target layer size. If I try to replace the layer's animation, but no layer is selected, Motioneer generates the animation using comp layers named missing layers. And of course, they got everything from the expression to the parent link to the track matte. Because the missing layers are compositions, I can enter the comps and I can add anything. I'm gonna add some text, replace. Then I get back to the animation. The text is present in the animation, of course. I set the background color to black, so I can disable the solids in the missing comps. A star for the box comp. And done for the last layer. Well, the comps are a very flexible way to work with because it is also possible to modify the comps size if needed. That's all, guys. If you are interested in the full version of Motioneer with presets support, here it is the link.